So let's set up a still life to draw. We start with a backdrop. And there we go. Just put it out like this. Thank you, Miss B. All right.
I accidentally turned my back on the camera.
That's okay.
Just turn to the side.
Me too. Me too. Okay. So there's our backdrop. Can you give me some things to put on our still life? Ooh, something round.
That's a mirror.
Well, it's a balloon. Kind of depends on which angle you're looking at it. Okay, give me something else.
A box.
A box. Let's put the box right there.
Okay. So it can be like a green screen almost.
Oh, yeah. Okay, something else.
Banana.
Oh, banana.
Like a dead actor.
Put, what are we going to do? Oh, we'll put the banana up here. How's that sound? Ooh, and something else. Ooh, that one's tall, so it needs to go toward the back. All right, one more thing.
Nice
candle. Okay. Now,
candle holder.
No, I think we're going to put it down here. Now we need to show everybody what we're going to do with it. So, it's sort of set up.
I found a different shape.
That's okay. We don't need any more shapes. Then what you do is you take your viewfinder.
What? You made a new viewfinder.
I made a new viewfinder. What do you think? Yeah? Okay. And look out. Okay, here we go. And you look at your still life through the viewfinder and you say, oh, that looks pretty good. Then you come down here, grab a pencil, and do what's called a thumbnail. And you draw your sketchbook. Oops. Draw on your sketchbook. And then...
thumbnail.
Yeah, your thumbnail. And then you go, oh, there's my balloon, and here's my little candle. Here's my box. Here's the banana. And here's that big candle holder. And does it all work well?
Yep.
Well, you don't know until you actually start trying it out. And if these shapes don't work well for you in the shape that you started out with, you go back to your still life, you rearrange things, you look through your viewfinder, and you keep playing with it.
Right here, my viewfinder is good for me.
Yeah. And then when everything is where you want it to be, that's when you transfer it to your larger canvas or your drawing paper or something like that and get started.
Can I make one of these?
So, when you have everything all arranged the way you think you want it to be, turn on your light, and now all of your objects have a shape. Make sure you draw your shadows, and that way everything will have dimension.